This week we're in Ulaanbaatar, and we're holding a workshop looking at the use of data and statistics to assess and develop policy around the rather serious problem they have here in Ulaanbaatar to do with air pollution.
So this is a workshop that's funded through the Global Challenges Research Fund. Research England have funded it, and it's jointly delivered by the University of Bath through the Department of Mathematical Sciences and the Institute of Policy Research and the National University of Mongolia here in Ulaanbaatar.
This is a sort of partnership that's been in development, particularly over the last 4 years, I guess, and it's taken a focus on air pollution because of the very particular issues that UB have around air pollution. I think it's the coldest and the most polluted capital city in the world.
Air pollution has been a really severe problem for the last decade or so in the city of Ulaanbaatar. And this is caused by, in large part, I think, by the Gir district. And in this winter, a lot of the Girs are burning raw coal, and that leads to lots of smoke.
So we've been thinking with academics and some policymakers and people from NGOs to actually understand some of the challenges and how we might help them think about that, both from the policy side and the social science side. I'm a social scientist, as well as the thinking about data and statistics.
I came here 2.5 years ago and today, and I'm more here as an observer this time. And the distance that has been traveled in those 2.5 years is remarkable.
We have people from the National Statistics Office, National Development Agency. We have people from the Public Health Institute, now named the National Center for Public Health. We have people from the National Center for Health Development. We have people from the Medical University. We also have participation from UNICEF. A number of people are attending from the Cabinet Office. There are people from the Air Pollution Department at the City Administration as well.
I'm from the Medical University, so of course we're really curious to know it's like the health impact of the air pollution on the human being. And at the same time, we also want to see like the impact of the decisions from the policymakers, how it's impacting to the human health.
UNICEF has been trying to work out what can be done for children to reduce the risks associated with air pollution. And one of the areas we've been looking at is understanding the issue in more objective and in more detailed way.
In the morning, we've been working on exploring how data can inform policy. And in the afternoon, we've been looking at that data and understanding how it can be used and analysed.
So in the morning sessions, we've used a range of activities to actually engage people. We've tried to keep the sort of just talking to a minimum.
So Mentimeter is an interactive presentation software we've been using this week. And the idea is that we wanted to gauge audience understanding and opinions of the topics that we were talking about this week in relation to air pollution.
My job in the workshop this week has been to present our training material and work with the questions from the participants to improve their technical abilities in R, but also their abilities in interpreting the statistics in a usable manner.
Everybody needs statistics nowadays. In fact, that's the recurring theme that whenever we meet somebody, either from developing countries or from industry, they say we have a lot of data, but we just don't know what to do with it.
One of the capacity gaps the country has is in analyzing data, overall data management, overall data analysis culture. So it's an area where we appreciate any collaboration and contribution. And
in my country, we cannot buy very expensive programs like SAS and Stata, and we only use the SPS. So if you learn the R, we can also update ourselves on the internet. We can search it and we can have the new version from the internet. This would be very beneficial to the developing countries like us, and especially for the people who really work on academia.
at the Institute of Mathematics, jointly with the University of Bath, we've been working quite a lot on statistical capacity building, and we believe that this is instrumental in improving both policy making, policy implementation, and monitoring the effectiveness of these policies.
There is a lot of data available in Mongolia, but it really hasn't been mined successfully in order to create the knowledge that could inform policy. So statistical capacity is very important there to enable Mongolians to use that data in a practical way to help them make better policy decisions.
It's been a great atmosphere at the workshop. I've really loved seeing everybody starting to talk together, to come up with new ideas, to bring together a lot of stuff that we felt that we knew, which is now in a bigger environment and has a bit more focus to it. And we're hoping that we can take that forward into new research directions, perhaps a couple of papers and publications that will come out of the workshop in a collaborative sense between us and the participants at the workshop as well.
It fits the strategic goals of the university, which are to do research with impact. So what we do here, we immediately see that it could have a very strong impact on Mongolia.
We actually ran a survey in UB this last week. So we had a process of survey design. We worked with a company out here. We've been able to actually use that to stimulate participants to think about research question development and analysis and so on. And I think that's going to be a very useful legacy from the project in lots of ways.
So for future work, we're looking at applying for further funding from the Global Challenges Research Fund. And this will pertain to both capacity building events, but also to joint collaborative research projects.
We are looking at a number of other opportunities for capacity building. We've submitted the EPSRC funding proposals for specifically this purpose. And there are other players from the Mongolian side as well that are very much interested in partnering.
So I would like to thank everybody who has participated in this workshop. I found it extremely rewarding. I've thoroughly enjoyed talking to all of the participants, especially in the group work. Thank you very much for coming, and thank you.